5, 4, 3, 2, 1. One out.
Next flag up.
Hi, it's Greg Clark with another race committee short about doing Vespers Race Committee on Thursday nights. Now what you can do is you can get ready to start taking finish times. Now, this is not one design racing, it's PERF racing, which stands for the Performance Handicap Racing Fleet, which means all these boats have handicaps, which are based on seconds per mile. So there's a few things that you need to know accurately as race committee. You need to know how long the course is, exactly how long the course is that was sailed, and you need to know the exact time of when each boat starts and finishes. Now, the start time's easy because the start time is not when they cross the line, it's when they're supposed to cross the line. They're a problem if they don't get there on time. So you'll know the start times for divisions 1, 2, and 3. Those start times will be, if you had three separate starts, 1900, 1905, and 1910 respectively. The harder part is getting the finish times. And the finish times, you'll want to record on a piece of paper. It's good to have two people watching the finish line when boats come across, and having at least one other or two other people recording those finishes when they cross the line. Something I always do too, I always have with me, is a digital recording device. We're probably going to record tonight on the camera, so I probably won't use this. But just flip on the digital recording device whenever boats start to come in, so that if you have to, you can go back and you can listen to it in real time or in non-real time when you have a little bit of time, especially if it's a big fleet with crowded starts. I've done race committee for one design fleets that have 200 boats. Talk about crazy finish lines and having to sort out 200 boats going across the finish line. Luckily, we don't have that many in Vespers, but have your digital recording device, make sure it's turned on, and then you can go back and listen at leisure after all the boats have crossed to make sure you have stuff in the right order. The next thing we'll talk about, make sure you use the same clock to start, to write down finish times that you used when you started. So Junior has on it, whoops, let me turn it right side up, this GPS clock that is tied to the atomic GPS clock. It's set to that. This will be about 3 or 4 seconds off of the time on your cell phone or the time on a GPS. They actually do not match. So this says GPS time, but it's technically atomic clock time. They're 3 or 4 seconds off. I won't go into why that is. The other thing you need is you need a finish sheet. And the finish sheet will be on a clipboard. Again, you want to have at least one person or two people who are writing down the finishes. You don't need to worry about division. You don't need to worry about anything other than the sail number and the exact time that they cross the line. Someone, either the PRO or someone sighting the line, will have a canister, a horn for the first boat, and usually blow a whistle for the second boat, and they will be calling out those numbers before they get to the finish line. And when you hear the whistle or hear the word mark, that's when you take the exact time and write that time down for that boat. And then you can sort out and figure out how to score it after the race.
Do you know the name of this boat?
We've got 1933.
1933. Just have Indus coffee in after we get the until it changes.
All right, I'm going to give you names. So the first one is going to be, looks like it's going to be 39. Maybe close. The other boat is Wave Rider.
We're working on 1935 right now. 1935.
Okay. Here so comes 39.
14.
Thank you.
39.
Great course, guys.
18.
316.
Pull off.
28.
And that last boat is
1, 2, 2, 5.
1, 2, 2, 3, 5.